next we've got Bernard Mueller from Consensus Sources.
All right, so the topic of the application takes some of all of us, but I'm told that I've only got 15 minutes to do it, so I try to speed things up. In this talk, I'm going to talk about a couple of tools that we've developed that can be citizens, one of them is open source tools or listening. This is a symbolic analyzer for detecting one of the two smart contracts. The other one is the X, between the verification API. And I would like to start this by giving you a brief visual representation of the development of Mueller. So I started 2017, and the red guy is me, and a lot of other people started contributing, and some tests were added, and yeah, you can see what happened. It worked pretty nicely. Yeah, so, the thing on the right side is the integration test. That's the thing to do. This is very good where we are now. So it's a pretty powerful symbolic execution framework that you can use a lot of different stuff. So I'm going to go over this very quickly. The technique here is simple to test. Or symbolic execution. So imagine you have a contract like this that represents a cat and there's one function that's called extend that. And you have a boolean variable that says, oh, you can either allow the cat to survive or you can kill the cat by setting this to false. So there's two possible ways that this can work. Either you go down the this path and you reach the stopping function of the happens, or you go down this path and the contract surface sets. So, most of you will know that we have these sets of code in solidity, and then that allows you to kill the contract, to leave the code, and from that, we will have these contracts. In symbolic execution, we follow down this ways, but every time we encounter a conditional chunk, we actually take calls at the allocated start with the path constraints that are imposed by the chunk condition. So we say, okay, if this extension is true, we go to the stop. If this extension is true, we go to the kill. And the last thing we can do now is we can go to any state that we want everything that is undesirable. And we can solve this equation and we get the input data we need to get a good state. And we can compute the complete transactions that we need to send to kill that contract. The basic of this material for the Python tools to install it, to run it, analyze, and you can run this either on CMD code or on a contract on the mainnet or the Python application. So I show you a quick demo of that. So a very well-known incident that you might be aware of is Terry Wallet, I believe. That was accidentally killed. And the reason for that was that there was an unrationalized variable. Anybody could become the owner of the contract and the actions that could be killed. And from this point of view, we detect this just fine. And I'm just going to show you a compressed video of that because in reality, it takes a bit longer. So to run this film, we just say run. So that so the name of the contract, in this case, we only want to look for suicide something to the original, and the output like this. So we detected one bug. This name of the contract is this location, and these are the precise transactions we need to send to the backup. So based on using the CC code, we can actually compute the premise. So the first transaction is in wallet, and this will move to the wallet of the contract, and the second one is the return, and we also compute it in a way that all the things will be sent to the second transaction. Yeah, so there's a couple of challenges with the symbolic execution, and it moves very quickly. One is positive. So it looks like something like student change. This was the batch overflow, finish overflow, because it's last year. So I saw the finish overflows in a context that are not really relevant because we don't have access to many brain body that are not as ready. For example, in SafeMath, if you look at this code, if this calculation actually overflows, but it will always be called by an asset, so you will never be able to use this value. So we need to find a way to eliminate these things before only the relevant issues to the relevant. This is the algorithm, this is for a switch over that, show the demo. So now it is on the previous chain contract. So this should return exactly one overflow, which is the one that is called the demo effect, but not the other ones, which has spurious overflows, and this also works. So if you look at that, this was the exploit done. The application overflow. And this is the transaction, and if you record this, it is the function signature, the first 4 bytes, and then it comes out and it is passed away. So this is the result, it comes out of the way. And then I think here somewhere, there should be a very large integer that covers the rest of the application. Another challenge is for improving the contract. Because if you go down 17 sections, the state of space that you need to do after the system of code exponentially, that means that if you go more than 4 or 5 transactions from the starting state, you become very computationally expensive, so you need ways to reduce this. It's really the visualization of it very briefly. So this is an execution over 3 transactions. So this is the initial block of code is executed, and as you go down the state space, you can see the process of transactions. So here the second transaction, you start from instruction 0 again, and so on and so on. So this gets really huge. So what we do is we found ways to prove states that are not relevant, and in different ways by looking at dependencies between state files and reads. And if I eliminate states that we actually don't need to look at, without understanding this. That means that we get a really nice feedback that compounds over time, so for your process activities, it's a feedback of 100% and more. And that allows us to do really interesting things. And the last one I'm going to show you is let's say you want to verify when you vary the contract. So you have this small contract that's a bank, right? And when you create a bank, you create a contract, you give it initial balance and return. And assuming that the smart contract works as expected, then the balance can never drop below that. So it's not supposed to drop below that part because if you can deposit, withdraw, the balance is in the correct box. And what we can do now is create a derived contract to verify that this function always holds. So we create an assertion here. And we say, check that the balance of this contract is equal or higher than the transistor. And this is supposed to always hold no matter what happens. Now we can use a symbolic execution to verify that there are no ways to make this happen. And if you know what you're using on that, it will determine that there is a way to make this happen. So, for this kind of thing, we want to give a few extra options. In this room, you can tell it only to check for exceptions. will do it faster, but it doesn't start for all kinds of stuff. And we also studied how much transactions supposed to go down. The people then is true, but if you want to verify property and to get a confidence of the results, you just increase the parameter. So this change is that in this variation after four transactions. So apparently, if you send this transaction sequence, then you have found that. And the reason for this is to look closely. So, what happens is some guy deposits some liter, in this case it's 1 liter, because that's the minimum score. And the second transaction, the same person refunds the liter. And when you look at this function here, it sends the balance back to the sender. And it also actually increases the balance before. So what we can do now is withdraw the same amount again, right? And then withdraw more than maybe. So this way you can find a lot of interesting stuff. Okay, so finally we also build an API. Then you can do all this stuff a lot easier because it's integrated with Spark, Linux, efficiency for a lot of other environments. We have Linux integration, so if you go to the Linux page and you go to this extension thing, you can activate the security notification extension, and this will allow you to analyze any contract you have compiled. We also have a topic plugin, it's very nice for continuous integration at last for running analysis, marketing development. Just try out the tools. The open source version is Zika, and it's also available to the for awesome text tools. Integration for embarking, customer vision, studio, and so on. And we also go to the security practice of the factory, starting in a couple of days. We just provide, we have to show you all the tools, how to use them. Maybe if you want to build your own smart models, what is what I've done, custom properties, and this is a common relationship. All right, that's it.